Unfortunately, even though this cruise control system is a fantastic addition to your car, you can't always use it, especially if it's experiencing issues. In other words, this system will experience some issues and eventually stop working, just like any other system in your car. Fortunately, automotive experts were able to reduce the list and identify the 7 most frequent reasons why cruise control stopped working. Let's examine these reasons in more detail below. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Brake light switch problems. Generally, you'll need to depress the brake pedal in order to engage and activate the cruise control system. If your brake pedal lights have even a minor issue, the system won't recognize this brake light and won't know whether you're trying to turn it off or not. You could therefore handle situations where your cruise control is malfunctioning with ease. The cruise control system will automatically turn off if it cannot detect the brake light because it will assume that there is a problem with your car. Cruise control switch problems. The first and most frequent cause of your cruise control not functioning is the cruise control switch. The cruise control system is engaged or turned on by pressing this button. The cruise control switch may malfunction for a number of reasons, and if it does, you won't be able to activate the system or communicate with it in order to use it. As a result, you may mistakenly believe that the entire cruise control system is broken when all that needs to be fixed is that particular switch. Vehicle speed sensor problems. The cruise control system must recognize that your car is moving at the right speed. Since it must communicate with the vehicle speed sensor, how will this cruise control system function if the sensor isn't giving accurate data? So it should come as no surprise that if the vehicle speed sensor is malfunctioning, the cruise control system won't function properly. Therefore, in order for this system to function properly and be activated the way you want it to, you must first fix the speed sensor. The check engine light. To alert you about any issues, your car will communicate with you through warning lights on the dashboard. Yes, I'm talking about the check engine light. This light is a way for your car to internally communicate that something is wrong, but it won't specifically explain what's wrong until you scan the computer and interpret the error code. When the cruise control notices that your car has a check engine light, it will automatically assume the worst, believing that there is a serious issue with the engine or transmission. As a result, the cruise control system will immediately shut off. Electric system problems. The electric system is the primary energy source for the cruise control system, which is connected to numerous wires. Therefore, this cruise control system will have trouble communicating and performing its function if there is any issue with the connection or the wires. In order to make sure everything is operating properly, speak to your mechanic if you're having issues with the cruise control system and ask him to check the potential voltage throughout the entire electric system. Therefore, it won't interfere with your cruise control system's operation. Fuses problems. Did you know that the elliptic connections in your car are supported by a group of fuses that work together? These tiny fuses don't usually cost much, but they can cause significant issues or stop vital systems from functioning. If you have a simple blown fuse, your cruise control may not function. So check your fuse box to see if any other fuses have blown out before you become overly concerned and assume a complicated, expensive repair. If you discovered a blown fuse, you would need to replace it right away in order to get your system back up and running. The process of changing a blown fuse is simple and inexpensive. In fact, you don't even need a professional to complete it on your own. If you drive a luxury vehicle, however, and you don't feel comfortable opening the fuse box, you can always contact a mechanic who can quickly and cheaply replace it. Cruise control cable problems. Last but not least, the cruise control system involves a cable that needs to be connected safely. The system won't work properly if this cable is damaged or unsecured, and you'll need to identify the root causes of cruise control issues. Examine this cable and give it a quick visual examination. Try to tighten them up if you see any signs of breakage or lost connections. However, if something is damaged or broken, it is best to leave it to the professionals because there is a chance that you could receive an electric shock, which is a very dangerous situation. What is the cost of fixing a broken cruise control? It depends on the underlying cause of the issue. As we already mentioned, a number of parts could malfunction and affect how well your cruise control system works. You should budget between $125 and $400 to address the system's general issues. However, things become more challenging and you might not be able to fix your car because of mounting repair costs if you wait around for another issue for a long time.